Well, shalom, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for tuning in. On a, this video is being put together on a Sunday morning. I got this free piano, and it had some drop keys on it, and I didn't really know what I was getting into. I've never done really much on piano repair, but it's nice mechanical stuff. I was a mechanic for years, and I like this. Work much better. It's cleaner. It's more uniform. Between the different units. I never could get any consistency with vehicles. I did it for many, many years, and pianos are much cleaner work. It's just held together old world technology and bring music and harmony to people's lives. I think that's a wonderful thing, and I'm going to refurbish this piano. I got it for free, and it had all these broken, I think I've got 18 broken bell cranks, or what they call these things, is elbows. And I tried to glue them in a couple different ways. I tried airplane glue. I tried urethane adhesive. I tried some other high-end adhesive, and nothing holds. They're old, they're brittle, and the glue just doesn't work. Okay, so what I did was I started doing some research and learned how to pull the action. I didn't have to pull the action to do this, but it just made it more accessible. So thanks to the YouTube universe, I was able to see a couple of videos on how to do this work, and it's a universal repair. This is what's left of what I've done. I started out, that's a 30-watt soldering gun. I was worried about clamping down on the little bitty plastic pieces and doing some kind of damage to the whippin', which is the secondary assembly here. I was worried about, you can see that little steel pin in there. And this is what I did. Started out with thinking I'd be better off using a solder gun. And by the time I figured out actually how to do it, I was getting better at it. And I can clean all that out if necessary. But the thing is to clean them out, first of all, thoroughly. Get all the broken parts off. I've got a set of 90 of these replacements, so I'll probably go ahead and replace all 90 of them, or 88 of them. That way it's a way to sell the car. The unit is a refurbished unit. These are the drop wires, and this is what I used, was a genuine Irwin 4LN, 4-inch LN long nose. So there's something to be said for using the proper tools for this kind of work. It makes short work out of the parts that are stuck to the end of the drop wire. And there's a trick to putting them back in. So I'm waiting. I can do all this work. In the meantime, join me at the piano. Let me show you what I got here. When I took the action out, I didn't have to take the action out. I think I thought I had to, so I did. And it does make it more accessible. And you can see all the dust in there. I don't know if you can really see the shiny parts on the string where the hammers were hitting. I'm going to have to clean all that up and all that dust in there. Vacuum all that out. This is better than grease. I tell you, this stuff here, a dust mask and a vacuum cleaner, it takes care of it. You don't have to wash the engine. I'll go through it and replace all the parts that need to be broken or need to be fixed that are broken. And pull the keys and clean underneath, vacuum all that behind there. The keys are numbered. I did get that from somebody. So it'll be in good shape. It's actually a half flat piano. I got that one as a freebie, and I tuned that one up yesterday. It's a short scale piano, and 66 keys, And it makes nice music. Beautiful. So I expect that this one will too. And go to somebody's home where somebody's trying to learn to play the piano. And give them something to have some fun with. Thanks for watching.